So we're on our way to Coast Sand Road here. We're going to show you what this place is like, but first I have to put my phone in a cover so it doesn't get bloody wet. So just to give you context, this is what you're seeing. People going crazy. I think I've just lost Anne. Where did I lose her? Ah, here we go. So we're going to film a little bit of this going in. So even before we get to Koh San, it's getting pretty wet, I would say, as I'm walking into it. Closer to Koh San, we have to take a side street to get here, but you can see it's bloody a lot of people here and water getting shot everywhere. I don't know what they're doing with Koh San, but I don't even know whether they're letting people in. Let's just try and figure out what's happening here. I don't know what's worse, the people traffic jam or the car traffic jam. I only got people up there shooting hoses down on people, getting everyone wet. Looks like they're actually restricting the numbers of people going in the Koh San Road to celebrate. outside of Koh Sen Road. Look how bloody busy this is. I'm just gonna say the whole place is freaking crazy. I've never seen this Koh Sen Road so busy here. But it's a lot of fun actually, but you gotta keep your phone protected. So I've gotta put it back in the plastic. This place is absolutely crazy. Usually it's just Koh Sen Road that's busy. But as you can see behind me, every side street going in the Koh Sen Road is just busy as hell. And I'm completely drenched. But it's a mad experience. It is like a sardine can walking around here, but still it's fun. But bring a water pistol and just go crazy, or walk through and just let people throw water on you. It's up to you. Now this is the next morning at the hotel, and I just wanted to give some insight to Koh Sen Road during Songkran. And I would say get there, if you're a Westerner and a tourist sort of thing, or anyone, get there early, because we got there about 7:30 at night and it was super packed. It was super busy. You could not move. It was hard getting in there by taxi. Maybe use the MRT. The MRT is maybe what, I think we walked for about 20 minutes from the MRT to Koh Sen Road. I can't remember it for sure, but there was an MRT that we could take, and it was a lot cheaper than actually catching a taxi. From Sukhumvit, for example, a lot of the taxis were charging you anywhere from anywhere up to 500 baht they were asking for in cash. We managed to get one that just put the meter on, which is not that easy to actually do going from Sukhumvit to Koh Sen Road. Now, but when we eventually did start to get closer to Sukhumvit, about this time, the traffic jam was just so bad, we just got out of the taxi and walked the rest of the way. And it was super crowded, Koh Sen as a whole. You could not move. You were pushing literally like a sardine can at that time of night. And they had crowd control going, where they were letting some people out and letting some people in. All the side streets were completely packed. And there was like people selling water pistols. There were street food vendors everywhere. And there was people squirting hoses. You were not going to get through Koh Sen Road dry, I can tell you that, during Songkran. So wear clothes that are comfortable, that you don't mind getting wet, and get some plastic covers for your phone and any valuables, because they're going to get wet. That's what I'm saying. And a lot of my filming was done through one of the plastic covers, because I was scared of getting my phone damaged. I was going to take my GoPro, except I had left a part at home, which meant I couldn't actually put the plastic cover on, the waterproofing cover, which would have been better for filming there in Koh Sen, in that regard. But it still turned out okay, the filming I actually did through the plastic cover, I think. But tell me what you think. But I would say get there early. I really should have got there right just before Koh Sen opened, so that when I got in there, I could go straight to one of the pubs or restaurants and sit down. Because it just, yes, it was fun to a degree, but being stuck in a sardine can is not the best fun in the world. You just want to get in and get out. But the people that were managed to get into the clubs and pubs looked like they were having a lot of fun, and in the nightclubs and stuff like that there in Koh Sen. So get there a little bit early, so that you can go in and get yourself a seat, or get yourself a table, or get into one of the pubs and have a bit of fun. But anyway, be safe out there during Songkran and have fun. And if you like these sort of videos anyway, hit subscribe and hit like, I mean. But as I continue to put travel vlogs around Southeast Asia and Thailand in particular, where I live. Anyway, have a beautiful day.